Today's show is pre-recorded.
Y'all know what time it is.
Y'all don't know, y'all better ask somebody.
Hat on, suit on,
looking like the dapper dawn, giving a microphone, dressed like the $1 million, things in its cuffs.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all tell me, who could it be but Steve Harvey?
Oh, yeah.
Everybody out there listening to me, put your hands together for Steve Harvey.
Put your hands together.
I sure will. Good morning, everybody. You're listening to The Voice. Come on, dig me now. One and only Steve Harvey got a radio show. Today is it, everybody. On a real positive note, today is it. Today is the day. You know, when I was in high school, you know, my mother was a Sunday school teacher until she passed. I would walk out the door every morning on my way to school, and my mother used to say, "Listen to me, son. Hey, don't forget. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." And, you know, I didn't think much of it. You know, it was just my mama being religious, you know, my spiritual woman. So, you know, I just took it as that. But as I've gotten older, man, you know, that's registered more and more with me. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. That's pretty cool, man. What better blessing will you get throughout the day than the fact that he allowed you to live and see another day? See, sometimes, man, when you're young, you don't pay no attention to that. But all you got to do is keep living. Keep watching some people that you know not be here anymore. Go to class reunions and they smaller. See people that you really loved that meant a lot to you leave this world. And all of a sudden, man, immortality starts to matter a great deal to you. Some of us learn this lesson sooner than others. But I know when you're young, man, you know, you think you're going to be here for a while. You think you got time to play around. You think you got time to get it together. You got time to make the mistakes. But man, oh, man, almost every full-blown adult that I know will tell you and have said these words right here many times. And see, the reason I'm saying this is because I want you to hear them, because you're going to use them. If I only knew then what I know now, do you know how many people have said those words right there? Because in time, man, you gain so much wisdom. Oh, but it ain't like nobody didn't tell you, though. Somebody told you back then, hey, man, it's best to buckle down now. He said, hey, man, you better quit wasting time. Hey, look, do your best at all times. You know, stop worrying about that. I'm telling you, son, in a minute, them clubs ain't going to mean nothing to you. In a minute, that going out all the time ain't going to mean nothing to you. I can't tell you how many times I repeat it to my kids. But, man, today is a different day. Because today is the day that the Lord has made. So he gave you a shot today. If you woke up this morning or if you're finishing your day on your shift, he gave you a new day. Nothing bigger than the fact that he woke you up today. Now, why don't you do something about that? Why don't you take advantage of it? How about if you start today? How about if you stop hesitating today? How about if you stop delaying it today? How about if you stop procrastinating today? How about if you make today the day that you go for it? I mean, man, let's all just decide today. Let's go for it. Let's put forth a maximum effort today. I mean, really, man, what you doing? You ain't, look, man, take advantage of this blessing of waking up. Do something today. If you would just start the process, man, start that business you always dreamed of. Go look into that other job you always yearned for. Go get the training you need to get the promotion, man. Go back to school, man. Go see what you need to do to lift yourself to the next level. Stop waking up every day seeing how it's going to go and start waking up and do something about how it goes. If you make one step, he'll make two. But you could, people talk about it all the time. Man, it seemed like you always getting a blessing. Oh, man, when you're talking to a person, listen to this. If you're talking to a person and it seems like there's always a blessing coming his way, let me tell you what that person doing. That person is putting one foot in front of the next. That person is putting forth some efforts out there. And that's the only way God can bless you. God can only bless you with your efforts. He can only put his finger on the thing that you are doing or attempting. That's all he can help you with. There are no jobs walking up to your door, knocking on your door. But if you beating the pavement, if you sending in the apps, if you online scouring somewhere to work, somewhere to get a job, then God can touch somebody's heart to hire you. But if you sitting at the house every day smoking, every day drinking, but you wondered why you just can't get a job the couple times you done went out there, you got to, if you ain't got a job, you got to look, go get one every day. You got to go look for one every single day. You can't take no days off. How about today? How about today if we decide today is the day that we're going to make the move? Today is the day that we stop delaying, hesitating, procrastinating. Today is the day that we take a step in a direction to do something for ourselves, for our lives, for our family, for our wives, for our children, for our community, for our school. Do something today for crying out loud, man. Stop sitting in your own life in just a stew of misery. In your own life, I'm going to tell you something. If you are in a state of confusion, if you are troubling, if you're stuck on what to do next, you want me to tell you what's happening? You're not doing enough. That's what it is, man. See, when I get in a place, man, where I don't know what the next move is, it's because I done usually stalled out. See, this is the way God works. This is the way he's worked for me. Every time I'm busy and I'm about the business of always trying to live my creed, which is ABC. My motto is ABC, always be closing. I'm always working on something to close something. When you're so busy with the business of improving yourself and doing with yourself and becoming the best you can be, God is always working on your behalf behind some scene of something that you're in the process of attempting to close. But because you're not doing all you can do, you're limiting you. You are, because of your decision not to give your all in all. You're limiting the opportunities for God to put his finger on things and touch them on your behalf. I don't know if the average person really understands or knows what it takes to truly be successful on whatever level you're talking about. But whatever that level is, I don't care what dollar amount you've got attached to it, what level you got. If you have made the decision that you're going to be successful, I think that a lot of people, the average person, does not know what that means. Whatever level you've decided to be successful on, see, that's your level of faith. That's where you see your life at. Well, guess what? You got to maximize your efforts to even get to that level. So listen to me. If you want to be successful at your church, if you want to be successful in your relationship, if you want to be successful down at the daycare center, if you want to be successful at your college, if you want to be successful on your job, guess what? It's going to take all you got in that world to become a success. I don't know why people think that if you don't want to be where somebody else at, you ain't got to put forth that effort. Nah, I ain't wrong. You've got to put forth your maximum effort at whatever role you're trying to accomplish. Lord have mercy, man. How about today, though, y'all? How about today? Today is a good one. Let's make today the day. Let's get out of that. Let's get on with it. Stop hesitating. Stop delaying. Stop procrastinating. Start today. Watch God have something to put his finger on there. And that's all you're trying to do, man. To line yourself up with God's grace, you got to put out a lot of effort so God can put his finger on something. You feel me today? I sure hope you do, because I'm on one today. Let's go.
FM.com.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here. Welcome to the ride.
Yes, sir.
On this Tuesday morning, ain't it amazing? Let me ask y'all a question before we get started.
Yes.
Mm. What you got?
Do you got somebody in your life, maybe somebody you work with, that want it their way and not your way, and it all got to go together anyway, but if they don't get it their way, now they mad? You ever worked with somebody like that?
Not no more.
You did it one time.
I'm free from that. I don't have it no more.
Sound like people at church.
I don't have it no more. I have been released from that. God has delivered me.
Delivered all of that.
No more. Willie won't. I don't know why Willie won't follow that.
I never understood.
It does.
Won't he will. Yeah.
But yes, not anymore. I'm good. I'm happy to be where I'm at. Now, that's not shade. It's like I can't say nothing without being considered
shade.
No,
that's shade.
Sunshine. I'm just saying. throwing shade.
You got a right to be happy, Jay.
Yeah, you got a right to be happy. Yeah.
He don't want you happy?
I see. Now, that would be shade.
Now, that's shade.
That's shade right there. That's a little shade.
I can promise you he don't want your ass Yeah, he don't want me happy, so hell.
He can't. Oh, yeah, that's the
I ain't never seen nobody that do not understand how this works, man. That what God has for you, he has
it's for you.
True. You trying to stop what somebody else got thinking you going to have more. You still going to have what you got.
But he got plenty.
You know what? See, listen. Can I sum it up for you? And this is what I want to tell young people all the time.
Yeah.
About hate.
What's wrong, Jay?
Hate is created because people think life is a game. Mm-hmm. That if I win, you lose. Mm-hmm. And if you lose, I win.
Right.
Thus, people who look at life that way, they on the internet typing funky stuff about you that ain't true, thinking that's gonna knock you down and now they bigger. Mm-hmm. Life is not a game. Life is a contest. You just got to get in the category and get your own blue ribbon. But if you go to the county fair, they give out more than one blue ribbon.
Yeah.
See, this ain't the Super Bowl. This is the county fair. You can get in there for best pig. You can win it for best syrup.
Best pickle beets.
Dog, you can win that thing for best pie.
Best eggs.
Dog, you can get in there fattest chicken.
Yes.
Fried butter.
Yes. You can get in there for largest watermelon.
Yes.
Dog, life is a contest. It ain't a game. Just get in your category, get your ass a blue ribbon, and go on about your business. Me winning ain't got nothing to do with you losing, and you losing ain't got nothing to do with me winning.
So stop the hate.
No, that depends, though. Now, we talking about this radio show. Yeah, we winning. We winning.
Come on, now.
You are second, third behind me.
Right here. See, that ain't how you look out. You trying to teach them stuff. It's a contest.
I didn't say any of
that. Get your blue ribbon. You over there, you winning? You winning in the little group you in.
Uh-oh. All right, we got to stop this right here. We'll come right back with more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show right after this.
FM.com.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Well, it's time for something funny. And, Jay, this is about stuff you say to your neighbors under your breath. Please explain.
This has to do with we see our neighbors all the time. We're not that fond of them sometimes. So we speak, but under our breath, we're saying little things, little insulting things like, hey, how you doing? You need to clean up that last ass yard.
Keep it 100, Jack.
Keeping it 100. You got one thing.
Jack, Jay.
I just want this. Earl, how you doing? How you doing? Earl, my man. You need some curtains, man.
I want to see your
naked ass every night.
We see it too much.
How you doing, Franklins? Good to see you. Hope that boy stay home this time.
He just got out.
He takes vacations, Junior.
Hey, good to see ya. This is the fifth time.
Dang. Come on, nephew. Stuff we Perkins. Say to our neighbors.
Perkins, how are you? Good.
You should do something with that damn boat you've been having back. You got to do something with that damn boat. That boat don't even work.
We got deep restrictions. How
you doing, Miss Kennedy? Hey, how you doing? I smell that wee way over here. Across the street, yeah. I smell it.
Dale, Kim, how you guys doing today? With two stupid ass kids.
Oh, God, Steve.
Them half with me.
Not the kids.
Yeah.
With not them the babies. Stupid ass kids. This is stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath.
It's got to be seen. It's got to be seen.
Come on, Junior.
Hey, Smiths, good to see you. All right, now. I wouldn't be pushing my mama that long. Now, she got to do something. Three people.
Hey, Bob. How are you?
Good, good.
Wish you can stop your fat ass wife from swimming naked on her.
Really?
Just been scaring the hell out of my dog.
Morning, Mr. Anderson. How you doing? Yeah. How you got four claws on block and don't none of them work?
Four cars?
That
yard is a mess. Stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath. Come on, Steve.
Willis. What's going on, boy? I see you. Have a good one today. So glad he over there, because that breath for him. He couldn't hit that breath. He cut my grass last week.
He killed my flower.
He spoke to me and cut my grass last week with his breath.
Wow, that's bad. That's a dragon right there.
Hey, Johnsons, it's good to see y'all. All right, now, man. No, we good. We good. I'll tell you right now, I know a baby when he eat paper. I know that baby eat paper. Ain't got to tell me no more. I know that baby eats paper. Baby ain't smart at all. No, you ain't got to bring him over. No, we good.
Stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath. Tommy, go.
Leonard, hey. Nice day today. Good, good. Wasn't good last night. Damn police got you.
What?
I know you selling dope. I know you selling dope.
You called him.
Stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath.
Ethel, Herman, how y'all doing? So good. Ethel and Herman, my friends. My friends. Time for y'all put y'all mama in the hole.
Put your mama in the hole.
Just be bending over her ass up in the window. Put your mama in the hole.
Yeah.
You know, black people don't do that.
Hey, Mr. Mitchell, what's going on? Yeah, I'm good. You don't see that dog doing that, y'all? You just don't see it. Yeah. Just gonna
right
leave it.
Just leave it there.
Stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath. Junior.
Hey, what's up, Curtis? Hey, Keisha, what's going on?
Curtis.
All right, now. Ain't no way in the world no better than that damn loud. He ain't killing that. Way too much noise.
You been hearing
him. I don't even know how they touched both their stomachs. All right, man. I'm good, man.
Come on, nephew. Stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath.
Conley, yard's looking good. Looking real good. You come over this line, though. You come over this line. One more time with that damn lawnmower. I'm telling you now. You know what a damn line is. I know you know what a line is. You know my side. You know your damn side. Keep on doing it. Well, that property line means something.
Yeah, that really do, man.
It's invisible, really, but it means something.
You know what that line is,
man. Man, that's my line.
All right, I think we have time for two more. Jay and then Steve, close it out. Stuff we say to our neighbors under our breath. Let's go.
Come yeah. On, hey! Hey! What's going on? Yeah, I'm good. Ooh, she whooped your ass last night.
They got into a fight?
She, what? She told her? Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Come on, Steve. Close it out. Stuff we say to our neighbors.
Home, dog. Rita, Sydney. Hey. Could have invited me over to a little stank ass party.
Yeah. I don't know. They had barbecue and everything.
That's my barbecue and everything.
I know you ran out of room over there, but the last patio you done built.
I came over.
I love it.
All right, guys. Thank you. That was good. Thank you. Coming up next is The Nephew and Run That Prank Back.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Right now, The Nephew's in the building with Run That Prank Back. What you got for us, Neff?
My roommate, Benny.
Ooh.
My roommate, Benny.
It was loud in my ear.
That's how it's supposed to be. It's prank time. Everybody know it's prank time. Get ready. My roommate, Benny. Run that, cat.
Hello? Am I speaking to Devin? Yeah, this is he. Okay, hey, man, this is Chris. I live above you. I ain't never met you before, but you have you been calling the leasing office about complaining on me about I'm making too much noise or what?
Yeah, man, my bad, bro. I was trying to catch you, man. I could never catch you at home, man. It's just like, you know, bro. I work at night. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I work in the day. But I can't sleep at night, bro, because I don't know what's going on in your apartment. You know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to be in your business. I'm not trying to be in your business, player. I just can't get no sleep at night, man, because there'd be a lot of noise up there, a lot of noise, a lot of talking. And what you do is your business, bro. I'm just saying, man, please, dog.
Hey, man, but you ain't got to go to the leasing office, man. All you had to do, you know, was holler at me. They got me written up like, you know, one more complaint on me, they going to put me out or something.
Well, yeah, dog, like I say, though, I was trying to find you. You know what I'm saying? But I guess we miss each other because you work at night. I work in the day. So, you know, when you going, I'm coming. And when I'm coming, you gone. You know what I'm saying? Bro, I ain't trying to start no shit. I'm just trying to, you know, go to work and pay my bills, man. That's all.
I'll be at work at night, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get my hustle on like you trying to get yours on during the day.
Hold on. Okay, let's make it make sense. Bruh, if you at work at night, somebody in your apartment talking loud than a keeping me up, square business.
Okay.
You got a roommate or something?
No, somebody I ain't got no roommate.
Man,
you might have heard Benny.
Somebody in there talking loud, holding a conversation. It's like two people in there talking loud every night.
That's Benny, man. Benny be talking.
Okay, you say you ain't got no roommate, so who is Benny? Who is Benny?
Benny is my bird, my parrot. That's Benny be talking.
Oh, say, man, stop with me, dog. Listen, man. Why? Wait a minute. You trying to tell me a bird?
That's Benny, man. I done had Benny 10 years. That's my bird.
Birds don't even live that long. So now I'm up at night. I'm at the work because a bird? That's what you want. That's what you call me to tell me. A bird.
I call you to tell you. You ain't got to be putting these complaints on me, man.
Say, man.
But I'm gone at night. That's Benny talking, man.
What the Benny then? Your bird,
dog. Yo, no, hold on. You're Benny, dog. Wait a minute.
Hey, look. I'm telling you now. Do something with the bird then, or it's gonna be some consequences and repercussions. I'm talking about some fried chicken around this.
Hey man, Benny is like a family member to me.
Bird, toucan Sam, the chicken on the cornflake box, Kentucky chicken, churches, all that. Your bird.
Hey man, you don't tell me nothing bad about my bird. Okay, brother, you know what? Maybe me and you need to square off in front of each other, cause you don't disrespect Benny, man.
Hey, all right. You think it's some? All right. I bet that be on my table when I get home. If it's a bird, then I bet that be on my dinner table, man.
Hey, man, now you ain't finna sit here and disrespect me and try to tell me what you gonna do to my bird. Now you ain't finna do nothing stupid to Benny.
I tell you what. See, you can date. You at home right now, but you go to work tonight. I bet you Benny don't be at that tomorrow. I bet you we be finger licking good tomorrow.
Hey, man, hold on a minute, man. Wait a minute, dog. And what you can't do is start talking about what you gonna do to my bird. Now, I done told you, you filed for going to the leasing office calling me out, and now you on the phone. I'm trying to work this out with you, and now
man,
you...
Man, you ain't trying to work it out. Now, first off, you call me and tell me that it's a bird holding a conversation with itself. I'm the stupid right now. I'm the stupid for even continuing this conversation about a bird. It's keeping me up all night. Are you serious?
Man, maybe you need to get some earplugs or something, man.
Say, man, listen, bro. Listen. Whatever the it is, if it's a bird, a recording, whatever it is, you better do something with it. If it's a bird, man, I'm going to be so insulted if this is a bird. I'm a really.
It is a bird. It's Benny, man. It's Benny. You, all you had to do was come to me, and we could have handled this like me.
Hold on. Okay. We're going to handle it like me and then, first off. Leasing office wouldn't give me your name. What's your name?
My name, Chris.
Okay, Chris, I'm Devin. There we go. Listen, dog, for the past 3 months, you know what I'm saying, I ain't really been getting no sleep because of this bird. You say it's a bird? I don't believe that, but a bird, come on, dog.
That's my bird. Man. I ain't been it for 10 years.
Well, look, take the to work with you then. I don't care. Figure something out, but whatever going on up there with you and your bird need to come to an immediate halt, or it's gonna be some dog.
Hey man, what you can't do is threaten me about what's going on in my household, man.
Look here, you and Benny, Lenny, whatever the name is, you need to do something with that, or it's gonna be some real issues, man. Why am I going back and forth with you about this, and you keep telling me something about a bird?
It's a bird. What's the problem with it? What's the problem understanding that people have pet birds?
Say, man, I don't give a if you have a pet bird, but really, this talks all night long. How do you live with this man? Because the don't never shut up.
I tell you what Benny told me to tell you, though. Can I tell you what Benny told me to tell you?
Wait, Chris, bro. I don't want to hear what no bird told you to tell me. Oh my
Can
God.
I tell you what Benny told me to tell you?
What the f*** did Benny?
Benny told me to tell you this, that this is Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. You just got pranked by your boy, Sean.
You Are you serious, dog?
Devin, did I get you, man?
You got me, dog. You got it, man. That guy, I'm going to get it. I'm gonna have to wait till this dude get home, dog, and talk to him. I ain't talk so much to you about this supposed bird. I don't know what's upstairs, man. I mean, dog, I be up all night, you know what I'm saying? I'm missing my sleep. I'm missing y'all in the morning because I'm drowsy, hitting the snooze button.
I got one more thing to ask you, Devin. What is the baddest? I'm talking about the baddest radio show in the land.
Oh, man, Steve Harvey Morning Show.
There it is, my roommate Benny. Just wanted to do it.
Oh man.
Everybody got different kind of roommates. Mine just happened to be a bird. You understand what I'm saying?
Lord.
My roommate Benny.
All right, more of this crazy ignorant show, Steve Harvey Morning Show, right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Carla found this great article on hiring your relatives, your family members.
You always do, though.
Yeah, we're all on Team Tommy for the most part.
I'm on your team.
Jay, I'm always Team Tommy.
Jay is president and CEO
of Team Tommy, baby.
Yeah, but here's some information from the article. Here are the pros, Steve, okay, for hiring your relatives. You already know what you're getting. You already know. You don't have to guess. You don't have to think about it. You know because this is a member of your family, so you know this person. Here's some of the cons, though. It sends the wrong signal to other employees. Like they're not qualified for the job. They just got the job because he was your
relative.
They
don't be.
Huh?
That's true.
Uh-huh. Here's another con. A relative may feel the rules don't apply to, in this case, him.
That's so true about
him.
Yeah. For that one.
He just missed 2 days.
Yeah, but he didn't get paid, though. That's where the stain gonna come in. Right?
Oh, you
good thing he sold out all them shows.
He's gonna need it. All right, here's
so he working to compensate for his check.
Here's another con, Steve. Well, you don't necessarily do this, but other CEOs might not hire relatives because the con is you hold back from criticism or you don't discipline him. So in this case, you did. You did dock him his pay, right?
Man, I wish I would. How am I not criticize him? What is we talking about? If we're not doing criticism, why are we talking?
But you hired him, though, Steve.
That was not by choice, Shirley.
What do you mean?
My sister.
Oh, Miss
The only reason I ain't fired him is because of her.
Well, I wasn't a good hire, though.
You don't think he does good work, Steve?
Wait a minute.
You don't think I was a good hire?
Boy, if I could replay the days you missed, the times you called in.
From day one, though, Steve.
Dog, I can't even tell you.
You guys weren't even here on day one when Tommy used to call in from his bed.
Called in from where?
At least twice a week.
Yeah, asking if he had to come in.
Is that true, Tommy?
I was trying to get used to the system. That's all.
But you know, we were all here.
What
though.
Else you got, Shirley?
That's about it. The article goes on to say that issues with family members who come up. I don't even want to say this.
Oh, I've got new.
Wait.
Hold on, hold for this one.
Wait, just wait. I got to brace yourself. The what article goes on to say issues with family members who come up short.
Wow. Shirley, you didn't have to read
that. I was trying not to say it.
No, you were all this supposed to be
Steve
team.
Steve asked me.
You could have let that go.
He asked me. Yeah. It's his show.
As president, that was wrong. That was,
they come up where, Shirley?
It said issues with family members who come up.
Look.
Wow. Okay,
I do a pretty good job around here.
Who
man.
Come up short on the job?
They must have interviewed Tommy for this article.
Should be addressed just as they would any other employee.
Anybody else? Right?
But what if they're the shortest one on the job?
Wow.
That's pop ting right there.
Okay.
Well, got me a pop ting.
Got it out your system, sir. Got it out your system.
I don't know.
Feel better now.
I'm hollering.
You got it out your system.
Try to read it one more time.
I didn't write it.
I don't read it no more. We heard it.
We don't need to hear it again.
What'd you say, President and CEO of Team Tommy?
We don't need to hear it again.
Why she hollering?
Man, she over there kidding. She got water coming out of her eyes.
I think Steve asked me. Did you not ask me to read this again, Steve?
No, I didn't know. I didn't know what it was. You weren't going to let it go.
Okay.
I was going to offer you some other reasons why you shouldn't hire a relative.
No, Junior, I don't think I should. All right, Steve, let's get to the news.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ann Tripp.
Thank you very much, everybody. Good morning. Good morning. I know for a lot of folks, this feels like Monday, but it's actually Tuesday. In Florida, the remaining of that collapsed condo building in Surfside demolished over the holiday weekend over fears of what might happen because of Tropical Storm Elsa, which might have brought the structure down on the heads of the rescuers. So that's down. And Mayor Daniela Levine Cava says they used a special technique to do it.
The method of demolition, energetic felling. It's a process that uses small, strategically placed explosives and relies on gravity to bring the building down in place.
That is what happened. Rescue and recovery teams have resumed sifting through the rubble for more victims. At last count now, there were 28 people found dead, with some 117 others still missing and unaccounted for. Again, that number, 28 dead for sure and 117 others missing unaccounted for. Meanwhile, Elsa made landfall yesterday on the southern coast of Cuba after causing deaths of three people in the West Indies, and a state of emergency has been declared in several Florida counties, with the storm expected to reach Key West and the west coast of Florida sometime today, also bringing heavy rains later this week to Georgia and the Carolinas. In Washington, Democrats in the House are expected to continue adding lawmakers to the select committee being put together to investigate the January 6th attack on Capitol Hill. Donald Trump held a Save America rally on Saturday in Sarasota, Florida. There were hundreds of fans in attendance. Also, a sort of a plane that flew overhead, pulling a scrolling neon sign calling the event a loser palooza. It was sponsored by a group called the Midas Touch. It's a political action committee formed solely to keep Donald Trump from running again for office. Brett Meiselis is the founder. He says, quote, these are loser rallies where the biggest loser of them all whines, further incriminates himself, and rants and raves like a lunatic, unquote. That's his quote. Health officials say that while two-thirds of U.S. adults are now vaccinated against COVID, the virus has not disappeared because of a more infectious variant out there going around. Still, more than 200 Americans die each day from the coronavirus, you need to know. The city of New Orleans was treated to a 4th of July fireworks show on Sunday thanks to actor Will Smith, who picked up the $100,000 tab for it after finding that the city didn't plan for a pyrotechnic show for this year. He's in New Orleans working on his latest film, Emancipation. And finally, today is International Kissing Day. Oh, yeah. Now back to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
If you believe this new survey, the average American traveler hates going to the airport so much that they'd add 6.5 hours to their travel time if it meant they could drive and take road trips to their location instead.
Well, you know, it is a more enjoyable experience to drive for a lot of people. Mm-hmm. Because, look, I used to take buses. I'm talking about when we were touring.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, tour buses.
Uh-huh.
Like, for example, if I was going, you know, okay, all of us lived in Atlanta for a period, right?
Oh, yeah.
Like, if I was going to Birmingham to perform, I'm not going to get a plane. Or if I'm going to Orlando, mm-hmm. or I'm going to South Carolina, I'm going somewhere like that.
To a bus.
Regional.
I'm getting a bus, man, because if you got to leave in plenty of time, you got to pack, you got to get dressed, you got to get in the car, you got to get to the airport at least an hour and a half before. Mm-hmm. Then you got to sit there and wait.
Yep.
Then you got to board. Then you fly. Mm-hmm. Then when you land, you got to go to the baggage claim, get your bag.
Hate that.
Then you got to travel to the hotel. By then, you could have been where you was going.
Yeah. That's true.
Now, and you need to stop, Steve, because when you get your bag, that's a 2-hour wait. That's longer than the flight to get the bag.
I'm trying to tell you.
Oh, my gosh.
Baggage claim. I have stood there.
I don't know who working back there, man.
I know.
But when you see them throw your bag at it.
Yeah.
No, I saw you, though.
Yeah, you're right, Steve. All that time when you, all that when you think about it, you could get on the road, put your luggage in the trunk, and be there.
And you just get to spend time.
In a couple of hours.
Yeah, spend time with me.
More relaxing.
Yeah. I don't want to spend no time with nobody, Jimmy.
Huh. We took the bus when we went to Albany from Atlanta. Remember we had the show down there?
Yeah.
All of us on there. We was having fun, weren't we? I thought we was.
Maybe just you.
See?
Well, maybe it was just me.
Yeah.
I'm glad to be anyway.
He done changed again. We back at that. Let's go on, call it what it is. You ain't been in no damn baggage claim in a long time, no damn way. Your bag come right off the back of your plane, so I don't even know what you're talking about. You ain't even stood in
Tommy,
no baggage claim, huh?
What's his frustration?
He ain't got no frustration. Roll out there up to his plane. Get out, walk up them steps. He on his plane. Ain't nobody telling him to get off the damn phone or nothing. He talking all the way through the flight taking off.
Look
at God. There ain't no seat belt on or nothing. Just sitting there. And sitting there pulling out, let me tell you what kind of cigars I got now, boy. Look
how God has blessed your uncle.
But once again, I ain't mad at it.
He ain't mad at it. Damn show sound like it. And then he get on the plane. Then he come and all he got.
Yeah. 73% of Americans, Steve, agree with you. They consider road tripping a more pleasant experience than flying. You got to take your shoes off. You got to undress. You got to, oh, my God.
You know, we'll just lay on there naked and just go on through it.
Coming up, some more music and more fun on the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, get ready. We consulted an expert because we wanted to know the real deal, okay? Steve is here with his breakup handbook.
All right, these are things that you need to have in mind after the breakup. Mm-hmm. Most of this is for fellas.
Yeah, that is.
Because when we take a breakup hard, it's ugly. It's ugly out there. Now, these are things from Steve Harvey's breakup handbook. How to act when you break up. All right, now, here's rule number one. You are allowed only one drunk dive. You know how you call them up when you're drunk?
Uh-huh.
You only get the one. And it sounds like something like this. Hello, it's me. You know who me is.
Don't play with me.
You know who me is.
Don't play with my emotions.
Who is me? You know who me is.
How many you get?
One.
You get one.
You get one of them?
All right. Now, here's the next rule. You are not allowed to roll up on your ex just cause you see their car parked outside the club, the restaurant, or church. Don't go in there.
Says who?
You can't do that, Shirley.
We broke up.
Yeah.
I can't go in there if I see the car.
I know she didn't hear praise
you can, no, you can't roll up on her.
She you in there praising the Lord?
No, I got something to do with church later on, but just stay that. Stay out right. You girl can't roll up on her. Okay. Oh, there she is. I'm going to go in there.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is. I'm going in there. You can't do that.
Call her.
Okay. Keep going. Keep going.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
All right, next one. Y'all's favorite spot is off limits to both parties for at least 4 months.
That's right.
Can't nobody else over there.
Yeah. Why you get to go to the spot? Right, right. Yeah.
At least 4 months.
Keep it 100. Yeah.
Here's another one.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Texting your favorite song to each other is off limits. Yeah. You can listen to it. You can cry to it. You can play it over and over. But you can't send it.
Send me this today.
Damn song. Yeah. I'm trying to move on.
And I'm telling you.
Everybody, hey. Now listen to this one.
And you.
All y'all stuff.
Uh-huh.
All possessions mm-hmm. is collected at one time and one time only. Anything that's left behind will be thrown away by both parties.
I like that.
You ain't
like
gonna keep that. Coming over here looking that's for fair. Stuff.
That's fair.
You see my red shirt?
You can't keep coming back shirt. Over here. I got company you in the closet looking for your tank top.
Oh, he keeping it real.
Man, uh-huh. Here's another one.
He should know. Uh-huh.
Hit a big one right here.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody is allowed to talk to each other's mama.
There we go. That's a round of applause, baby.
That's a good one,
yeah.
That's a good one, Steve.
Leave my mama
I can't be
out of
friends
this.
With your yeah. mama, mm-hmm. and you can't be friends with my mama.
I come home, you sitting up there talking to my mama. What the hell?
Yeah. Did you hear that, Lisa? That's a good one, Steve. I like it.
Hey, I'm over Jones. Here trying to pick up some greens, and you in here talking.
Mm-hmm. Rolling your eyes when I walk in the door?
Yeah.
Now, here's the next one.
Yeah.
Okay.
All parties should find a new church home.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Yeah, that's
definitely.
Fair.
Yeah, we can worship together.
I love Pastor Wiggins.
Well, you can't go there no more.
Next. Not no more.
All your friends should be divided up equally, mm-hmm. except the ones you hate.
Oh, you can have him. You yeah. can have
Here's
her.
Another one.
Uh-huh.
No posting of nude pictures.
Yeah.
You know, like her naked mm-hmm. or him Wait dressed up like the damn Easter Bunny.
That was the private.
What about? I'm gonna finish this one. Up.
All right,
I
listen.
I wanna know about old naked pictures.
All right. Well, nephew, tell me, has a prank fall coming up?
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, nephew, what you got? Time for the prank phone call.
Shirley, it's time to baptize some people. It's called mobile baptismal pool. Oh. Mobile baptismal. We come to you and yeah. baptize you.
I ain't
you
even heard it and I like it. It sounds good.
You know it's going to be ignorant. You know
we come
this.
To your house and baptize you. That's what we do. Here it is.
Hello?
Hello, I'm trying to reach a Mr. Wilson.
It's Wilson. How you doing? Who's this?
How you doing? My name is Brother Springwater, man. Listen, we got paid to actually come by and do some services to for you by some friends of yours. And we wanted to actually call and see about scheduling and see what you had available.
Some services. What, y'all plan on cutting some grass? What y'all do? What kind of services y'all have?
Actually, sir, you've got some friends that have actually spent a great amount of money on you. And what we do is we have a baptismal on wheels service. And what we do is we go and we baptize people at their home. And Baptism on Wheels has been it's a new company, but we've baptized over 1,000 people now. We have a truck which actually has a baptismal pool on the back of it, and we actually come to your home and we will baptize you in your driveway and make you whole again. So
Brother Water, Brother Spring, what's your name again? I'm sorry,
Springwater.
Springwater, you want to come to my house and give me a baptism in my front yard?
We want to baptize you right there in your driveway. Your friends are paid for the services. And
What friend will pay for me to get baptized? Man, I've been baptized already, Doc.
Well, from my understanding, baptized. Sir, that evidently you've had some some bumps and bruises, and they seem to believe that you need to be washed and cleansed again.
I mean, that's all good. That's all good. But I mean, be that it may, man. I mean, I've been baptized. I go to church. You know, me and the Lord don't have no problems. I mean, we all have setbacks. But for you to pull up with your pool in front of my house to say you finna baptize me, that doesn't make any sense to me, Doc. I mean,
sir, sometimes when some people are not able to go to the house of the Lord and get baptized, you know, we're making it a lot more convenient for you.
I don't need no convenience. What do I need convenience for? You asking me to come to my house on a Tuesday to baptize me in my driveway, does that make any sense to you, Brother Water? I mean, come on. If you really sit back and think about it, does that make any sense to you to come for the convenience?
First of all, sir, that's Brother Springwater. But what I'm trying to say is
holy water, spring water. It doesn't make no difference to me. You can't come to my neighborhood and baptize me in front of my house.
Sir, what is all the angle? This is what your friends are talking about.
I don't give a damn what my friends are telling you, man. Which one of my friends gonna recommend you to come to my damn house?
Sir,
that don't even make any sense to me. You understand?
I'm not at any liberty to tell you who actually.
But you're in the liberty to come to my damn house and baptize me, but you can't tell me who the hell go see you. But you're not at liberty. What type, man? Come on. Does that make sense to you, Doc? Come on. That doesn't make any sense. No way in the world I'm going to allow you to come and bring your pool in front of my house and baptize me. Then I'm asking you, you're supposed to be a pastor. You're supposed to be baptized. I'm asking you, okay, which friend of mine is sending you to, you know, letting you know I need to be baptized? You're going to take me out at liberty?
Sir, all I want to know, basically, I've already been paid. I'm calling, asking you about your schedule. You're not baptizing me.
I've been baptized.
I'm going to baptize you on Tuesday in your driveway.
Man, I tell you what, if you come to my house in front of my driveway, you better bring the whole congregation. You understand? You better bring the deacons, the brothers, the sisters, and everybody else. If you think I'm going to be baptized in my
This is the problem. This is what your friends are talking about. This is why you need to be baptized and cleansed again and washed in the blood of the Lamb. This is what's wrong. You need to be cleansed. That's what's wrong with you, Mr. Wilton.
What's wrong with me? No, what's wrong with you is calling me in the middle of my work day telling me I need to be baptized in front of my house. If I need to be baptized and go get some holy water, I go down to the church. I don't need you coming in front of my house making a whole circus with all your friends and some white sheets talking about you want to baptize me.
From my understanding, Mr. Wilton, you've missed two Sundays already this month.
Two Sundays? Man, I can go anywhere and get the word. I don't need you coming here because you're telling me I missed two damn Sundays. I'm going to miss this Sunday, too, because the football game coming on.
Sir, all I know is I've been paid to do a job. I will be there Tuesday morning at 7 o'clock, and we will baptize you before you go to work on Tuesday morning.
I tell you what. You come to my house at 7 o'clock in the morning. I swear on your Lord, I'm going to bust your You understand me? You will not come to my house telling me you're going to baptize me. I don't give a damn who paid you. You understand? I will drown your in the water. Matter of fact, now, bring you, your deacons, and everybody else, we're going to have a pool party in that. You understand?
I'm going to get all of this anger and all of these problems you have within you. We are going to purge your body and get it out your system.
I don't want your cleansing me. I tell you what. Brother Springwater, is it that's the call?
It's Brother Springwater. You go get baptized on Tuesday morning.
I don't give a damn who pays you, who calls you. Bring your I'm going to I guarantee you, I'm going to dry you on sight.
I got one more thing I want to say to you. Would you listen to me?
Matter of fact, I'm busy. You ain't got to say to me. I got to go. You understand?
I got one more thing I want to say to you. Is you listening to me?
What, man?
This is Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. You just got pranked by your boy Mason. Hello?
Man, let me tell y'all something, man. Boy, let me tell you something, boy. Y'all was about to bring some head up to heaven. I was about to act a fool on y'all if y'all would have showed up at my crib. You understand me? Boy, Tommy, y'all ain't got just better to do than to sit around here and just with people doing their day. Man, I ain't never thought y'all can get me with this. Hey, who in the hell goes around baptizing people on, that's like meals on wheels. How y'all baptize people with a pool on the back of your F-150?
Hey, Wilson, you know? I got to ask you something. What is the baddest radio show in the land?
Man, you know it's the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
See, that's how you baptize somebody. They
ain't,
Forget going to church now.
Exactly. When they don't make it to the church, you know, we bring the baptismal to you.
It's right outside.
We right outside.
That's actually a good idea.
Yeah, we in the driveway.
Money maker right there, man.
Yeah, we'll baptize you before you go to work in the morning.
Yeah. Mm.
And get your save on. We get your save on right there. We cleanse you right there in the driveway. Won't he do it?
Yeah.
Won't he will.
And will he won't. That's all I'm saying.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Right now it is time for the Strawberry Letter. If you need advice on relationships, on dating, work, sex, parenting, and more, submit your letter to steveharveyfm.com and click Submit Strawberry Letter. We're ready, nephew.
Buckle up and hold on tight. We got it for you. Here it is, the Strawberry Letter.
Subject, I'm in love, but not with my husband. Dear Stephen Shirley, I am a 30-year-old mother of two, and I've been married since I was 18. Well, recently, I met a man online and initiated a conversation with him about sports since we like the same teams. I was completely attracted to him when I saw him online, and we decided we should meet in person. And once we met, we started out as friends, and we talked to each other and saw each other daily. I started to have strong feelings for him, and it grew into us hugging and kissing whenever we were together. Here's the catch. He is also married to his high school sweetheart, and they have four kids. He says he is in love with his wife, yet he still finds time to talk to me and see me. Whenever he posts pictures on social media of him and his wife, I get jealous. I see how happy they appear to be. I have tried to leave him alone, but it never lasts for long because I like him so much. In case you're wondering, I cannot stand my husband, but I've been with him my whole life and our marriage is comfortable. Besides, I have my kids to consider. I know what I'm doing is wrong, but now I am head over heels in love with this man, and he doesn't want to let me go, but he's not leaving his wife. What should we do? Well, I don't know what we should do, but I definitely know what you should do, okay? Listen, this is a go-nowhere, hopeless, hot mess of a situation, and you know that. This needs to end right now, today, but it probably won't because you are head over heels in love with this man, as you say, and he has already told you he's not leaving his wife. So, you know, you're in somewhat of a quandary here because you say you love him. I say that if you're unhappy in your marriage, get some therapy, get some marriage counseling, talk to your husband. Maybe you guys could try different things, get a separation, do something else, but don't just sit there and wallow in unhappiness while seeing someone else on the side, you know, behind your husband's back and him behind his wife's back. That doesn't help anything. I know you want to... What, nephew?
Nothing.
Are you squirming in your seat, though?
All over it.
Jeez. Anyway, yeah, he's not leaving. So what are you guys? You're just destined to sneak around and see each other that way? Is that what you really want? You say you want to stay married to your husband for your kids. I mean, that's good and that's noble and everything, but you got to have some happiness in this situation too. And if you're not happy, if your marriage is not making you happy, you got to do something about that. First of all, I say get some counseling. All right, there you go. Steve?
Yeah. Yeah, that's nice. And get yourself some counseling. All that ain't worth a damn. I'm tell you that right now. We're going to skip
don't
over that. This
that.
Letter don't say nothing about no damn counseling. This 30-year-old mother, here's the subject. I'm in love, but not with my husband. Now, that's the only time I hear you say the word love in this letter. I must point this out. 30-year-old mother, too, been married since you're 18. Probably dated the boy since before that. You've never had any other relationship. You know, met this man online. Y'all started talking about sports. Then you saw him. You was attracted to him. Y'all decided to meet in person. Once you met him, y'all started out as friends and you talked to each other and saw each other daily. Mm. Now, you got to go out your way to meet somebody daily. This ain't a coworker. Hello. This just a dude offline. So y'all got to hook up. That take time. So y'all making ways to go see each other. Now, both of y'all is married. We'll get into that in a minute. I started having strong feelings for him, and it grew into us hugging and kissing whenever we were together. Hell yeah. See, y'all out of sports talk. See, that old we like the same team? How much liking the same team gonna get you? Every day? Y'all just up talking about the same damn team? About how much y'all like him? Nah. He looking at your lips, you looking at his lips. Y'all putting your tongue in each other's mouth.
Wow.
You're damn right every day. Sitting up talking about the team. Nobody talking about no team every damn day. The Browns, as much help they need, they don't talk about the damn team every day. Here's the catch. He is also married to his high school sweetheart, and they have 4 kids. He says he's in love with his wife, yet he still finds time to talk to me and see me. Okay, listen to me now. Read your line back to yourself. He says he's in love with his wife, yet he finds times to talk to me and see me. He ain't in love with you. He ain't in love with you. I'll explain that to you in a minute. Whenever he posts pictures on social media of him and his wife, I get jealous. That's his wife. What you jealous for? Put some pictures of you and your kids and your unhappy ass husband on there. And smile at it. I see how happy they appear to be. I've tried to leave him alone, but it never lasts for long because I like him so much. Now, first of all, if you think that I'm going to sit up here and believe all y'all doing is hugging and kissing, you're wrong about that. You're leaving stuff out this left. Every day, just hugging and kissing.
Every day.
And the subject, I'm in love but not with my husband. Well, what are you doing to make you be in love? Because the show ain't talking about sports.
Ooh, LeBron. Go, LeBron.
Most people been in love with me.
Go, James Harden.
I'm just trying to say.
Come on.
It's because of what I do.
Oh.
It ain't the Browns.
Mm, it ain't the Browns. It ain't the Cavs.
Cavaliers either.
Yeah. It ain't Houston. Yeah.
Go Rockets. All right, listen.
We'll be right back.
Yeah. We'll be back at 23 after.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, guys, here we go with Steve's part 2 response to today's strawberry letter.
Yeah, and this 30-year-old mother, and that's why I met this dude online.
Are you
Set
mad
up in
at
here
her?
And start feeling something for the dude. They meeting every day now, hugging and kissing.
Every day,
hugging and kissing. He married, got 4 kids. She married, got 2 kids. He says he in love with his wife, yet he still feels time to find time to talk to me and see me. But I better understand something about men. Men can be in love with somebody else and find time to see and talk to you.
Yeah.
But know this now. He ain't in love with you. He's not going to leave his wife. Mm-mm. I've tried to leave him alone, but it never lasts long because I like him so much. What? That a minute ago, you was in love, but I like him so much. Because of what he do. It ain't just a hug and a kiss. In case you're wondering, I cannot stand my husband. I know you can't stand your husband because you're over here talking sports with this man and talking sexiness with the sports. You see him dunk that ball.
Dribble.
Did you see that ball go through them uprights? Right down the middle, wasn't it? Did you see him tackle him? Fell all over him, rolled him over and everything. I sure like the way the quarterback put his hands up under there to get that ball.
Wow.
We just talking sports now.
Yeah,
that's why
that's
we just sports talking. Throw it deep. Girl, you better throw that thing to me deep. Go long.
Okay.
Just go long. We just talking sports now. Mm-hmm. But go long.
Is this still sports?
You need to get a penalty flag. You illegal use of hands. Yeah, just
I can't believe we fell in love like this. We was just talking sports.
Still sports talk? Okay.
Sitting up in here, man. Hold it. Here, my turn. Let me kick the ball.
Oh, man.
You like a wide receiver. You got soft hands.
Who's the tight end?
All right, Shirley.
You know.
Yeah. Sex talk. I mean, sports talk.
I'm the tight end, too. Yeah, we sports talk. All right now. Sitting up in here. Uh-oh.
What?
You roughing the pass. You better quit doing that to me. You sure better quit doing that to me. Well, so now after y'all done talked sports and had sex.
Exactly.
Now you can't stay in your damn hood. Been with him your whole life and our marriage is comfortable. Besides, you got kids to consider. Now here's the key to the whole thing, and this is where I'm going to start to helping Tommy out. I know what I'm doing is wrong, but now I'm head over heels in love with this new man. He doesn't want to let me go, but he's not leaving my wife. What should we do? Well, let me explain something. He doing what he gonna do. He ain't got no other plans. You is the other plan. See, the man is doing what he do. Now, since both of you all are married and both of you all are in a consensual relationship, I'm going to tell you something that a young man told me. I never understood this, but he used to use this all the time. The saying is, fair exchange ain't no robbery. See, you married, I'm married. You got kids, I get kids. You in love, I'm in love. You ain't going nowhere, I ain't going nowhere. But we getting together to calm a problem and solve a problem that we both have.
There we go.
Now, is that right? 100% no, it isn't. No. It is 100% morally dead wrong. But ain't we all sinners? Mm.
Yes.
Saved.
Ooh,
by grace. Ain't we all come short of the mark?
Yes.
Ain't we?
Oh, come on now.
We went from sex talk to a woman.
Coming milliliter short of the glory of God. Ain't we,
yes, we are
guilty of life's lust for pleasures?
Yes, we are.
Who in here ain't been tempted? Who in here ain't wanted somebody that wasn't yours? Who in here ain't looked over there and wished they was over there with them?
Yes.
Who in here ain't had something cross their mind and wanted it to stay there and visit for a while? Yes. Who in here ain't said something inappropriate to a woman somewhere, hoping that it led to something inappropriate? I want to know who amongst you ain't took the time to say, look at here, what you think, how you want it, make it mine, give me some. Wow. I like it like that. Touch me again. Ooh, baby, that's hot. Oh, right there. Come on now. Can you come back over? Who in here ain't said this?
All right.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Steve, what's something you feel like you constantly have to explain to people?
Something that I constantly
have to
explain.
To people.
You want truth or answer?
Yes. We don't want you to lie.
A thing that I'm trying to get past is my lifestyle.
Oh,
I get tired of explaining that. Mm-hmm. I can't tell you how many times. Why y'all do that? Mm-hmm. You know, you could have gave this to this. It's people over here that ain't got nothing, and y'all spending this money on that. Mm-hmm. I spend a lot of time dealing with that.
Mm-hmm. But you give.
Yeah.
You have a foundation.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You can't give enough to people.
That's true.
Yeah. You can give until you ain't got no more, and then they just move on to another
time. Give your last, huh?
But I get tired of explaining
myself. I'm through doing that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm through doing
it. And you give to us. You give to people that are close to you.
Very generous. You're very generous. Yes.
And thank you.
But like Bishop Ulmer told me, for those who love you, no explanation necessary.
That is so true.
For those who hate you, no explanation acceptable. Yeah.
Yes, and when we ask you, Steve, I mean, we ask you a lot of stuff, too. Right. I mean, but we work together, and we just want to know. Exposure's everything,
absolutely.
You know?
Absolutely.
Yeah, the blessings come down, man. Right. Blessings flow down.
All right, what else you got?
Come on, Carla. You got a question.
I do. Mm. Okay. So listen to this, Steve. You wake up, and you see you have texts from multiple family and friends. Now, half of the messages say, go outside. The other half say, stay inside. Mm-hmm. What do you do?
Half of the messages say, stay inside.
And the other half say, go outside.
That's from family.
I'm going to stay inside.
Yeah, and then from family and friends, you got a whole bunch of text messages.
You're going to stay in?
I'm going to stay inside. I can control most of what's happening in my life. Go outside. You're opening up yourself to what's outside.
Okay.
See, I know what's in here.
Mm-hmm.
There ain't nobody in here. You can't get in here. I got alarms. I got security.
Okay.
I'm going to stay in here.
All right.
Mm-hmm. I ain't finna go out nowhere.
That's smart.
That's a good one. You like that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. All right, come on.
We're playing Ask Steve. Come on, Junior.
All right, Unc, what is the dumbest, and I mean the dumbest rule you had in school?
Say it again. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you did, what? Mr. Change of Attitude.
My attitude's fine. What is the what now, Kim?
What's the dumbest rule you had in school?
This one, elementary.
Okay.
Two people can't slide down the sliding board at the same time.
Who are you trying to slide with?
I'll be damned.
Who are you trying to slide
now,
with?
We ain't got but 30 minutes,
huh? Do the math.
You see this
trying
line.
To get as many in.
If you let two, three of us slide at one time, we can probably get a couple slides in for the
Right.
That's your logic.
This ignorant ass, one person at a time, and wait till they get to the bottom and clear the area. What?
Rules.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, let's go. It is time, guys, for Comedy Roulette.
I love it.
Comedy Roulette, Jay.
Let me break it down, Steve. I got to. We got new people, Steve. Mm-hmm. Steve.
I'm saying what?
You know his nerves are bad, Jay.
All right, here's where we take five subjects. We put them on the wheel. We spun the wheel. Where it stopped, we will do the damn thing. Hit it, Shirley.
All right, here we go. The five categories. Number one, excuses people use who owe you money.
Yes, do that.
Yes. All right, number two, doctors don't always know what they're talking about. Okay.
There's some old people saying that.
Number three, why are you talking? Your team sucks. Okay. Number four.
No, Jay ain't got nothing for that.
Uh-oh, number four. I think I took the wrong pill.
That's me.
Okay. And number five, and that's when you realize you were lost. Okay? All right, spin the wheel, Cap. We'll see where it stops.
Come on, doctors.
Yeah. I like the doctors.
I took the wrong pill.
Oh, it stopped at number five, guys. And that's when you realized you were lost.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
You, this is when you realize you lost.
Okay.
Yeah, we got to turn the music down so you can concentrate.
Yes.
You
got to look right.
Yeah. Can't nobody concentrate with this loud ass.
Yes. Yes.
Don't y'all see me lost?
I'll tell you when you know you lost. And this happens all the time. When you drive and the street signs go from English to some right, you can't even recognize. You trying to figure out, I don't even know what.
I don't even know where.
Is this still Maine? That's all I need to know.
Let me tell you something.
Uh-huh.
When you riding and you in the middle of nowhere and you see a sign that say 10 miles to Jurassic Park, man, your ass is lost, man.
Not Jurassic Park.
Jurassic.
Go ahead, Steve.
Come on, Steve.
God, I should know so many of these.
Yeah,
when you driving and you mutter to yourself,
uh-huh.
That ain't the damn house.
Yeah. Here's when you know you lost.
Come on, Jay.
You make a right turn,
uh-huh,
and it's a no exit. It's you.
You lost.
You right in the cul-de-sac.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah,
no.
What the hell am I doing?
It's a circle.
This is when you know you lost. Anytime you got to put your car in reverse and look over your shoulder.
Back all the way back.
You backing out.
You backing out. I don't know good damn well.
All right, go ahead.
When you ride and you see one store and get out and this white man say, you got any idea where you at?
That's scary on so many levels.
You get out of stop sign and you go, where the tree at that used to be right there?
Right.
There was a tree.
Right.
Right.
When you driving and you stop, and the guy said, sir, it's like the last time I told you. I keep telling you the directions.
Directions. This is how you know you really lost. I've done this quite a time, too. When you tell you gotta lean out your passenger window and say, my man.
Yo, my man.
My man. Hey, my man.
I got one better. Go ahead, Tommy. Go ahead, Tommy. You know you lost when you sit there and you say, you know what, I'm gonna leave my car and just Uber from here. I just don't know where I'm going.
All right,
this is how
Steve.
You know you lost. If you ever say these three words right here,
yeah.
Excuse me, little boy. What?
You're in the neighborhood street. Fast, little boy.
Excuse me, little boy.
I'm talking to kids.
Your ass is lost.
Yeah. Who you mean?
You need some help, babe.
You need
directions.
Serious help.
Excuse me, little boy.
What you need, sir?
All right, we'll be back with more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Okay, here we go. While some women may expect men to show their appreciation and love in grand ways, you know what I mean, darlings, most women would be happy with just a small gesture from their man to show how much they care. So what small gestures are we talking about, you ask? Well, a recent Reddit poll thread posed the question, and some of the gestures include just putting their phone away during quality time. You with your boo? Don't be all on social media, okay?
Yeah.
I'm right here. I'm
right.
All the social media you need, baby.
Yes, focus. Hashtag yes. Focus on me.
I'm an influencer, okay?
Right,
let me influence you. It shows, you know, that they're focusing. And some women say they love random little gifts to know that you're thinking about them, like flowers, you know,
right.
Things like that. Just
we love
things.
Flowers, sure.
Yes, whoa,
yes,
oh my
we
God,
do.
Yes, yes,
yes.
Just a hug. How about just a good old hold me hug? Okay,
yes.
What do you think, Carla?
I love that. I love those just little gestures. It doesn't always have to be big, you know. And then I think one of the things is just listening. Listening, I know our husbands, you know, both of us are married, and you know, our husbands, they want to fix it. You know, they want to fix it.
That's
just listen.
Men.
Let me vent. Let me go
off.
Yeah. Little gestures.
They don't want to hear it. They want to get to the solution.
Right.
All right, listen, make sure you follow us on social media. I'm on the gram at My Girl Shirley, okay?
Go ahead, and Carla. I'm at Lips by Carla on the gram. And what you got coming up, Shirley?
More of the Steve Harvey Morning Show at 33 minutes after, right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
If you believe this new survey, the average American traveler hates going to the airport so much that they'd add 6.5 hours to their travel time if it meant they could drive and take road trips to their location instead. Wow.
Whoa.
Wow.
Well, you know, it is a more enjoyable experience to drive for a lot of people. Because, look, I used to take buses. I'm talking about when we were touring.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
tour buses, yeah.
Uh-huh. Like, for example, if I was going, you know, okay, all of us lived in Atlanta for a period, right?
Oh, yeah.
Like, if I was going to Birmingham to perform, I'm not going to get a plane. Or if I'm going to Orlando, or I'm going to South Carolina, I'm going somewhere like that.
To a bus.
Regional.
I'm getting a bus, man, because if you got to leave in plenty of time, you got to pack, you got to get dressed, you got to get in the car, you got to get to the airport at least an hour and a half before. Then you got to sit there and wait.
Yep.
Then you got to board. Then you fly. Then when you land, you got to go to the baggage claim, get your bag. Then you got to travel to the hotel. By then, you could have been where you was going.
Yeah. That's true.
Now, and you need to stop, Steve, because when you get your bag, that's a 2-hour wait. That's longer than the flight to get the bag.
Oh, man, baggage I'm trying claim. To tell you.
Oh, my gosh.
Baggage claim. I have stood there.
I don't know who working back there, man.
I know.
But when you see them throw your bag at it.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, I saw you, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right, Steve. All that time when you, all that when you think about it, you could get on the road, put your luggage in the trunk, and be there.
And you just get to spend time.
In a couple of hours.
Yeah. Spend time with people.
More relaxing.
Yeah. I don't want to spend no time with nobody.
Huh. We took the bus when we went to Albany from Atlanta. Remember we had the show down there?
Yeah.
All of us was on there. We was having fun, weren't we? I thought we was.
Maybe just you.
See? Well, maybe it was just me.
Yeah.
I'm glad to be anyway.
He done changed again. Here it is. We back at that. Let's go on and call it what it is. You ain't been in no damn baggage claim in a long time. No damn way. Your bag come right off the back of your plane, so I don't even know what you're talking about. You ain't even stood in
Tommy,
no baggage claim, huh?
What's his frustration?
He ain't got no frustration. Roll out there up to his plane. Get out, walk up them steps. He on his plane. Ain't nobody telling him to get off a damn phone or nothing. He talking all the way through the flight taking off.
Look at God.
There ain't no seat belt on or nothing. Just sitting there. And sitting there pulling out now. Let me say what kind of cigars I got now, boy. Look at that. Look,
look how God has blessed your uncle.
But once again, I ain't mad at it.
He ain't mad at it. Damn show sound.
And then he get all the plane. Then he come all he got.
Yeah. 73% of Americans, Steve, agree with you. They consider road tripping a more pleasant experience than flying. You got to take your shoes off. You got to undress. You got to, oh, my God.
You might just lay on there naked and just go on through it.
All right, we'll be back with the close. Today's been a good day. We'll be back to close out the show. With Steve's closing remarks coming up at 49 after the hour. Right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, here we are at the last break of the day. Steve, we've had a good day, talked about a lot of stuff, and of course, as usual, it is time for your closing remarks.
Today, I want to keep it positive, but I want to keep it encouraging at the same time. And always, as usual, I just want to say this before I start. It's not that I think I know everything, because I don't. But in my 61 years, I have learned quite a bit. I have learned how to come from the back towards the front. I've learned how to be at the bottom and work my way towards the top. I've learned how to get over because I've been under. I've learned how to win because I have lost so many times. I've learned how to develop an understanding because I have been more than confused before. So I have paid for these lessons that I've learned. So I'm just sharing, and that's all I'm doing. You don't have to take any of this that I say to heart, or you may choose to go another way. But for those that are really open to just hearing some theories of success, that's why I decided to start doing closing remarks again. Today I want to talk to you about something that really helps everybody. And it's very simple. Get focused. You got to get focused, folks. You've got to become what I call laser beam driven. You've got to set your goals and visions up, and you've got to put those blinders on that you see on the horse. See, the reason they put the blinders on a horse is so that the horse's peripheral vision doesn't distract him. If you have up in New York and you see those carriages going around Central Park, all those horses have on blinders is so that they can keep the attention of the horse straight ahead. Blinders are very good. If you want to be successful, you're going to have to put on a pair of blinders. That's so your eyes, when you look left or right, it forces you to get them back out front to where you're trying to go. See, because those blinders block out distractions. They block out distractions because they know you got to get laser beam focused if you want to be successful. You have to focus. You have to stop veering off track. You're just making the journey longer. You know, they say the quickest way from point A to B is a straight line. Now, in life, it doesn't work that way. There is no straight lines. But you can avoid some of the detours, some of the distractions. But you got to quit veering off track. Everybody come to you. You can't participate in everything. Hey, man, we going out tonight. Hey, man, we going over here this weekend. Hey, man, come on, man. You ain't got to study. We getting ready to do this. Hey, man, don't worry about that. We going to happy hour. Come on, man. You can't go to everything. Stop veering off track. Next, look at it like this. Get your mind made up. Get your mind made up of what you want to have in your life, the legacy you want to leave, what you want people to think of you as, how much money you really want to make, where are you really trying to go, how do you really want to be viewed, what do you really want to accomplish? Get your mind made up. Here's another way to look at it. Make a decision. Stop just wandering around. Life is a series of decisions. Make one. Just make a decision today. Make a decision. In other words, come to a conclusion. Man, just sit up and say to yourself, you know what? This is the deal for me. This is what works best for me. This is who I really am. Skip the outside interference from your friends and your relatives of what they think you ought to be and do. What's really good for you? Don't nobody know what's best for you better than you. Come to a conclusion. Make a decision. Set a goal. Have a vision. Get thirsty. Want something so bad that without it, your mouth tastes dry. You got to get thirsty, man. See, when you're thirsty, you got to get that quenched. You have to quench your thirst. And that's how you got to pursue success. You got to pursue success like you thirsty. You got to be thirsty, man. You got to want something so bad that if you don't get it, your mouth tastes dry. What are you thirsty for? If you ain't thirsty for nothing, you ain't giving it all you got. I'm telling you, man, this is how I look at it. These are just some triggers that I put in my head. Be relentless. You got to be relentless about something. Being a relentless person has a carryover effect. If you get relentless about your dreams and goals, do you know that makes you relentless about everything? If you develop these positive characteristics about being successful, you can get there. You got to get focused. You got to stop veering off track. You got to get your mind made up. You got to make a decision. You got to come to a conclusion. You got to set a goal. You got to have a vision. You got to get thirsty. You have to be relentless. If you're not, you will veer off track. If you veer off track, you will never get to where you're trying to go. You got to get focused, y'all. It's as simple as that. And if you know how to do it, ask God to show you how. That's the other thing. No matter what I tell you, if you include God in everything I'm telling you, it becomes a lot simpler. You know, God can help you get focused. Anything you're short of, he got plenty of. God in the make your dream come true business. God is in the turn your life around business. God is in the pull it together business. God in the get over business. He can do it. So if you don't know how to get focused, ask God to help you get focused. And then make a decision to be focused and get on with your life. Make something happen today. Those are my closing remarks today.
All right, Steve.
Hey, can I tell y'all something?
Yeah, 10 well, seconds.
Have a great weekend.
Tuesday.
Oh, Tuesday.
For all Steve Harvey contests, no purchase necessary, void where prohibited. Participants must be legal U.S. residents at least 18 years old unless otherwise stated. For complete contest rules, visit SteveHarveyFM.com.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.